comes to Christmas specials and movies around this time of year, you always expect something sentimental, something nostalgic, something that really captures the spirit of the season. But what if you don't want something like that? There's a solution for your not-so-holiday blues with 2015's Krampus, directed by Michael Dougherty. But what is Krampus? Think of him as an anti-Santa Claus, a goat-like demonic entity that punishes bad children by whipping them with switches and eventually dragging them down to the depths of hell. Some fun, right? The spirit of Krampus has picked up in popularity over the years, so it seemed inevitable that they'd make a movie based on him. And the best way to describe the Krampus movie, although it is a Christmas horror film, it's also darkly comedic like the way Gremlins is. The story is simple. Young Max still believes in Santa Claus. However, in the days leading up to Christmas, his extended family comes to visit, and they're the worst. They're actually pretty bad, but at the same time, they're exactly what a lot of people deal with when it comes to extended family. With his own family's apathy coupled with the extended fam's pushing it just a little too far, Max has enough. He's done with Santa Claus, he's done with the holidays. He rips up his letter and throws it out the window. And that's where things go to hell. Max's neighborhood is covered in deep snow and set in heavy darkness as Krampus sets about to do his own special work. What Krampus looks like isn't really explicitly shown until the last third of the movie. However, he has more than enough henchmen that are able to do his work for him. From evil Christmas cookies to demonic toys to, oh god, when that evil jack-in-the-box claps its hands upon the arrival of the elves coming. Ugh, that's a nasty scene. As the movie progresses, Max's family is picked off one by one until Max has to have a showdown with Krampus himself. Now here I'm going to get a little bit into spoiler territory, as the ending is very open to interpretation, and I think really there are two ways you can look at it. The ending resolves with Max waking up, being reunited with his family. The house looks back to normal, everything looks picture perfect, until Max opens up a present that holds Krampus's bell of warning. At this point, the family remembers everything, and the camera pans back to see the house in a snow globe in Krampus's workshop. So here's the thing, either Krampus sent a warning to always keep Christmas in your heart because from now on he's got an eye out to watch you, or the ending where they're basically condemned to a purgatorial hell where it's always Christmas forever and they're trapped inside their house for all time. I've gone back and forth on which ending I think is the more accurate, and my consensus is they make it quite explicit that Krampus never gives, he only takes. And I think basically he's condemned them into this snow globe torture prison of his. However, before the movie release, there was a graphic novel called Krampus, Shadow of St. Nicholas, where basically it does show a number of characters being tormented by Krampus who had lost the spirit of Christmas in their heart, and the end chapter essentially resolves with them learning their lesson, each receiving a Krampus bell, and going on to keep Christmas alive. Whether or not it ever pans back to show that they're in their own snow globe hell, I don't know, but my thought? Once you get a visit from Krampus, you're basically screwed. Krampus is a scary movie. It's not over-the-top terrifying, it's not over-the-top gory, but it does get intense because basically this giant demonic Santa Claus is hunting you down at all times, and even before he makes his appearance, he sends all of his minions after you, and it's not good despite how funny or weird that they are. One of the more visually interesting scenes in this film is when Max's grandmother reveals that she's also been visited by Krampus in her childhood. And it's presented as like this Rankin-Bass stop-motion animated special, and it looks really, really cool. And basically you learn that she made the same mistake of not keeping Christmas in her heart and not believing in Santa Claus, and Krampus came to punish her entire family, leaving one of those bells to her as a warning. Michael Dougherty's work on the dark side of Christmas is great. It's fun, it's scary, but it's not too surprising considering he also worked on Trick or Treat as well. Would I recommend Krampus? I think the real question is, did you like Gremlins and do you consider that a holiday movie? While Gremlins is a little debatable as a holiday movie, even though it is set firmly in Christmas Eve, Krampus is definitely a Christmas movie because the spirit of Krampus is inexplicably tied to Santa Claus. And that's what makes it so creepy. I've enjoyed doing all these heartfelt Christmas specials, but I thought I'd drop a lump of coal into my last one as a little bit of fun. I'll be doing more Christmas movies next year. If you have any suggestions, please drop them in the comments below. Otherwise, I've got a few in mind, and now I've got to wait 12 additional months before I do the next ones, but you do what you can. Anyway, thanks so much, you guys. I've still got one or two more videos before the end of the year. Thank you again, and happy holidays. Take care.